We often talk about spending capital, and by far and away, the most badass check I've ever seen cashed is by Mahershala Ali when he traded his Oscar win, his second Oscar win, to become Marvel's Blade. If you haven't heard the story, what did he do after he won? He called up Kevin Feige and said, "Things are looking pretty good for me, and you know, I'd like to be Blade." And as I always tell you, the squeaky wheel gets the grease, and Kevin Feige made it so. Now, at 46, Mahershala Ali is older than the way Marvel likes to cast their lead actors these days, which is, and I emphasize these days, this is a very stupid rule. I mean, it kept Charlize Theron from really being in the running for Captain Marvel. She would have been phenomenal. I mean, I think Brie Larson's doing an okay job, but she's no Charlize Theron in the role, how that would have worked out. Anyway, who built the MCU? Iron Man. And Robert Downey Jr. was 43 when he debuted in the role. And I will say that I feel, and I think anyone who's seen Alita Battle Angel feels, that Mahershala Ali as Blade is as good casting as Robert Downey Jr. as Tony Stark. It's gonna be good. And if his two Oscars don't convince you that he's a good actor, watch True Detective Season 3, where he knocks it out of the park. Wow, I was a Mahershala Ali fan before that, but I became a Mahershala Ali stan afterwards. And here's a fun fact, his co-star there is Stephen Dorff, who's also phenomenal, and he played, of course, the big bad in the very first Blade movie. Yes, there have been other Blade movies, which makes this unlike other Marvel franchises, where people actually enjoyed the Blade movies and have not been praying to the movie gods for Marvel to get the property and get it right. I mean, I think they want to see Blade stories continue, so that's why people are excited for the announcement of doing a Blade movie, even though it's so far off, was incredibly well received when it was made at the end of the presentation at Comic-Con. It was a very big deal because people like the character so much. And whenever we talk about comic book movies becoming so popular today, and you know, it really did start with Spider-Man and X-Men, but people point out that before Spider-Man and X-Men could run, Blade walked. And that's true. That's very true. So I'm sure that hopefully that will be, I'll make it part of the conversation when this Blade movie finally comes out, that it's a big part of comic book movie history. But also, I think adding vampires to the MCU, oh, that's going to be tricky. Tricky, tricky, tricky. And I have a couple of ideas on how they could do that. Now, MCU, this, as you can see, this is an idea video. Now, MCU's Blade doesn't have a release date just yet, but I believe, as I've told you before, that it will get the October 7th, 2022 date that they currently have reserved. Blade is a perfect fit with the first Venom movie. The second Venom movie was going to open this at this time, too, but it got pushed because of coronavirus. But first Venom, Joker, and now the Batman movie, Blade fits with that group very nicely. And for 2022, this would make Marvel's roster Thor Love and Thunder, the new roster because of the date shift, because of coronavirus. So Thor Love and Thunder, Black Panther 2, Captain Marvel 2, and then Blade. What a lineup! So here are my top 5 ideas for MCU's Blade, and I encourage you to share your own down below. All right. Jordan Peele, Jordan Peele, Jordan Peele, Jordan Peele, and Jordan Peele. No, don't worry, I have 4 other ideas, but I think Jordan Peele is that important to the success of this film. Allow me to explain. He's a horror brand, He's also a comedy brand. I mean, that's so important to Marvel, comedy. And here you have someone who is both. It's phenomenal. It's the same reason I think Sam Raimi got the Doctor Strange gig. He's both good at horror and comedy. Jordan Peele is such an obviously perfect choice for this. All right, so Jordan Peele is also highly regarded as an artist, but fans also love him. And he's a leading voice in quote-unquote Black Hollywood, a role and a responsibility that he takes very seriously. Jordan Peele would get Blade right, able to deliver in terms of representation on 3 different fronts. Comic books, because he would take that seriously. Horror and Black entertainment history. Great references. I can see that throughout a Jordan Peele Blade movie. I mean, just look at the references in Us, just in Lupita Nyong'o's in the summer home where they were vacationing. All the wonderful things they had to dance and all that, and throughout the whole movie, Us is, that's another great way to watch Us, to see all the references to Black entertainment history. And I would want that in Blade. I think you're going to see that in Candyman, although Jordan Peele isn't directing that movie. That's very important to remember. All right, number two. They got to bring in Wesley Snipes. They got to do it, even for just a cameo. Probably for just a cameo. But, you know, Snipes was gracious enough to congratulate Mahershala Ali publicly when he got the, when it was announced that he was taking over the role. And I think now it's the MCU's turn to be gracious and give Wesley Snipes a cameo. I think Wesley Snipes is probably a little bit difficult to play with, and, you know, he would be difficult to keep in a cameo, but I'd be like, just on set for one day, Wesley, and we're just all going to make it work. All right, number three, Elsa Bloodstone. Oh, I like this idea a lot. And Marvel might already be planning it, because many of you have noticed that she's appearing in more comic books than she usually does. She's a real fringe character, but she's a great character. Think of her basically as a redheaded Maeve from Westworld. A killer British accent to go with her killer instinct and no-nonsense attitude. In addition to being a skilled monster hunter, and just a hunter in general, she's juiced up like Captain America, has a healing factor like Wolverine, and is immune to, wait for it, vampire bites, while her blood is poisonous to vampires. Oh, excellent. And the blood gem around her neck on that choker, it wards off vampires, and it glows when there's a supernatural threat nearby. Cool visual. Would love to see it in a movie. Elsa comes from a long line of monster hunters, the Bloodstones, in the UK. And they even fought Nosferatu in the pages of Marvel Comics. You know, another, of course, famous vampire from vampire lore. We'll get to Dracula in a moment. She lives and operates out of Bloodstone Manor like Lara Croft. Another good comparison. This family line of monster hunters works very well with my next suggestion. And that's number four. No Dracula. I don't want Dracula in the MCU. I think having to, because, you know, eventually Blade's going to cross over with the other characters. So I don't want to hear other Marvel characters talking about Dracula. I think it's just a bit too silly. But don't worry, I have an alternative. Just like the Bloodstones are a line of monster hunters, there's John Falsworth, a.k.a. Baron Blood, an English aristocrat who is immortal, who poses as his own children throughout the decades. In the comics, he fought Captain America during World War II, and that would allow us to loop in MCU mythology with the Blade movie as it hits the ground running. And sometimes there's a Baroness Blood as well. So you could have the Bloodstones versus the Falsworths in the UK, and Blade gets drawn into that. I think that would be phenomenal. You know, I wasn't sure about a Blade movie until I started to put these ideas together, and now I'm thinking it's going to be pretty good. So finally, on the subject of blood, number five, Wolverine. That's right, Wolverine. Now, I know in the comics it was Jubilee who was turned into a vampire, but that was super dumb, and no one appreciated it. She's not a vampire even anymore, because it was so dumb. You know what? It was such a bad idea, she's not even in the comics right now, because like, everyone's like, let's just walk away from this disaster. Now, recently, in a comic, Wolverine found himself targeted by vampires. It was a momentary dalliance, but it really spoke to me, right? So they were attracted to his mutant blood with its regenerative qualities. And what's more, thanks to his ability to regenerate, he's a well that never runs dry, right? In this comic, they had him hanging upside down with a spout coming out of his neck, like, you know, tapping a beer keg. I thought that was really clever. A beer keg, a magic beer keg that, as again I said, never runs dry. I think that's phenomenal. I would be quite inspired if I were a Blade filmmaker. These days, MCU movies do better with team-ups, and a younger Wolverine, pre his X-Men days, would be a fresh way to introduce the character to audiences and be a huge boost to this Blade movie. Plus, with his prolonged life, remember in the comics, he fought alongside Captain America in World War II, he also fits very nicely into the story with the Bloodstones and the Falsworths and Wolverine. And also with all this Cap stuff, Baron Blood, Wolverine, all in Cap's history, maybe we could get some Chris Evans flashbacks, which would also really help this movie. It's competitive out there in the movie landscape. You gotta have a really arsenal, and I think this is quite the arsenal. Not to mention, Blade and Wolverine have teamed up in the comics before. Mark Ruffalo has said he wants Wolverine. Better get to him first, Mahershala Ali. Now, I know some of you might want Morbius to show up. You might be like, how are all the five ideas done and you didn't mention Morbius? Kevin Feige has made it very clear that his relationship with Sony is not a two-way street, and he is very clearly building his own vampire mythology. Stay over there, Morbius! I think Blade is going to work just within the MCU. Not to say that maybe Blade couldn't go over to Sony. As I said, this is a one-way street, so I don't think Morbius is going to come here at all. I really don't. And let's see how that movie does, but it's been delayed. I just don't see it happening. Morbius would have to be such a big hit, so beloved by fans, that maybe for Blade 2 you could get a cameo. But these are a lot of ifs. All right, so what do you think of my top 5 ideas? Share your own down below. Subscribe today, and of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.